Good evening, friends. As I told earlier in the video, giving the introduction about the transmission distribution, I told you that the next going topic is going to be the structure of electrical power system. The figure what you are seeing on the board is giving the complete structure of electrical power system network. We are going to see in detail about the electrical power system network. I told you in transmission distribution basically comprises of three things. One is generation, transmission and distribution. Here in this structure of electrical power system, we have basically a generation and a transmission as well as a distribution system. And as far as generation is concerned, I'm talking about the Indian scenario. Generation is concerned, we have 11 kV level of voltage generation, 13.8 kV level of voltage generation and 15.75 kV level of voltage generations. And these generation need not to be like renewable or non-renewable. Maybe we can use any type. Most probably we are using non-renewable, and for the renewable level of generation we are using low level generations, even like 1 kilowatt, I mean like not 1 kilowatt, like 11 kV or 400 kV, even low level of voltage is possible in the wind energy generation schemes, as well as solar is something different. However, this is the basic level of voltage levels that are used in India for generation purposes. It may be thermal based, I mean like a coal based generation, or fuel, maybe like atomic power based generations, or even a hydro water generation, hydro based generations. The generation levels are in the three. And these generated voltage on the low level, before transmitting the voltage, is to be stepped up by using a step up transformer in the generation station itself. And this substation is called a generating substation, wherein the low voltage generated is stepped up into the high voltage before transmission. So, for example, the 11 kV generation is stepped up to 230 kV or 130 kV or 400 kV as required. And these are stepped up and then transmitted to the transmission line. Because in transmission point of view, the voltage which is transmitting from the point A, that is the generating station, to the point B, which is called the receiving station, we need to have a high voltage system of transmission. So the voltage which is transmitted is in the level of high voltage. Basically, we are now following 230 kV as well as 400 kV. But also, we have 785 kV of line, which is already tested. But it is not in use as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned. Okay, and it is coming under an extra high voltage system. And after, when the power is resumed at the receiving station, when the power which is resumed is in the level of 130 or 132 or 400, and again it is stepped up in the substation, which is called the receiving station, where we use the power transformers and it will be stepped up. And from this receiving station, again the power is distributed by some distribution transformers, or otherwise they simply call this as SS, substations, which is mainly used for distributing the power. Wherein we call these kind of transformers called distribution transformers, where again this 11 kV level of voltage is split into 400 volt in a 3 phase and 230 volt in a single phase. The 400 volt is used for the industrial purposes as well as for the higher level consumers, and 230 is for the domestic purposes and a single phase system. And this is again further classified into secondary distribution, where these secondary distributions are further classified into like a service mains, which is our consumers, every domestic houses, and some commercial consumers or small scale industrial consumers. Like this is also a main service main. Now, therefore, if you want to have a clear-cut idea about this, first we can talk about generation, and then primary level of transmission. Also, we have a separate secondary level of transmission. We have a primary level of distribution. We have a secondary level of distribution. These primary, secondary are based on the voltage level which it is operating. Okay, and this is the complete electrical power system network that I want to share with you. This is the first and core basic idea to understand the subject or a course called transmission and distribution. And we have some technical terms involved in this. You would have heard about the word called grid. So this is mainly, in colloquial words or nationally, we will try to call it as grid. So I want to share what is, what is our grid. And you might have heard about the word called LDC. These are the two important terminologies which is involved in this postal network. One is called grid, and next one is called load dispatch centers. And we have another called feeders. We have another called feeders. And we have another one called distributors. These are some of the terminology, technical terminology that every engineer has to learn in basics. And we call the service mains. So I'm going to give you a brief idea about what is called grid, what is called load dispatch center, what is called feeder, what is called distributor or distribution. So it's called not distribution, it's distributor. Not distributor and service mains. Grid. Grid is a simple, I can say it's a simple connector or it's a constant network, but n number of generation is put into and n number of load is taken away. So grid means it is having n number of generation involved in it and n number of loads are traveling. So it is like a power injection as well as the power dissipation. So in grid we have n number of generators connected at various places, and also we can able to take the power or distribute the power at various places, wherein the voltage levels as well as the frequency levels are almost maintained as a constant. Whatever, if you take a separate line, it is involving n number of lines, but if you consider a particular line and the connections of generators or the load dissipation is particularly based on the single voltage level as well as the frequency, almost in simple I can say a line which is consisting, where a line which is compromising of same voltage level and same frequency level are said to be a grid, or even we can simply call it as a bus bar or infinite bus bar. When n number of things are involved in it, then we can call it as a grid. When I say grid, national grid, regional level grid, zonal level grid, and we can, if you further, we can classify zonal level means it's a particular zone which comprises some small cities. Region, in sense, in a particular state, we have a west region, eastern region, northern region, separated into three or more or five different types of regions. As well as, if you want to have a grid, national level grid, I mean, we have a national grid like western zone, eastern zone, north zone, middle, or something like that. So it is separated as a small pools, and we can have a grid like structure. And we have one more important thing called load dispatch center. In between the generation and in between the distribution, the control is taken over by the load dispatch center. How much amount of generation is possible right now, and how much amount of demand is right now. So they will have a compromise between the generation as well as the demand, and they will try to supply the reliable amount of power to the consumer. Because when a system is delivering a reliable amount of power with a constant amount in a constant frequency, then only that system is called as reliable power quality system. The purpose of load dispatch center is to give the information or to always monitor the information of the generation as well as the demand, and they will take care of these things. And we have basically a load dispatch center as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned. We have in Erode district, we have in Hosur, and we have in Madurai, and we have in Chennai. We have almost four different load dispatch centers taking care of different zones. And coming to the feeder. Feeder is a main conductor, a simple conductor. A feeder is a simple conductor which connects a point A to B, wherein A may be a generating station, or A may be some receiving station, vice versa. B may be a generating station or a receiving station. It is connecting a point like A to B. It is connecting a point to A to B, wherein no tappings are taken for other purposes. No tappings are taken for other purposes. So feeder is a line wherein no tappings are taken in between the point A and B. And coming to the distributor, again, A is a sending point, or B is a receiving point. A power which is transmitted from A to B or taken away for distribution purposes. It means if the number of tappings are taken in between the transmission lines, then that is called distributor. And service means is again a conductor which connects the street, the pole, and the consumer premises. a conductor which connects the street poles and the consumer premises is called service mains. But all the conductors are in first one, there is no tappings. Here we are tapping, n number of tappings. Here again there is no tappings, but it is connecting two different levels. One is called, one should be a pole and one should be a consumer premises. These are some level of important terminologies that you have to know about transmission distribution as a basic thing. And in the last video, I asked you some questions regarding why we are going for low level of generation and why we are going for higher level of generation and why we are maintaining the voltage levels, the multiples of 11. Now, here is the answer. We have n number of authors has given n number of answers, but in my point of view, which I have learned and I am trying to conclude that the two different things. One is going to be the most important point, like if you go for higher level of voltage generations, then insulation is a very big problem, and insulating a higher level generation is not that much easy. It's going to be a tedious problem, and therefore insulation is taking the first priority in setting a voltage in the lower level. If you go for higher level, then the insulation of the thing, insulation of the coil for the higher level is not that much easy. In other aspects, I can say, like, if you go for a higher voltage system, say for example, instead of generating 11 kV into some like 10 generators, 11 kV into 10 generators means 110 kV, right? And instead of 110 kV as a single unit, say for example, here I am having 10 generators, here I am having only one generator, here I am having only one generator. So, suppose if there is a failure, it may be by natural or by short circuit or anything, if 110 generator fails, automatically we are not going to maintain the reliability. Therefore, this is a failure system. Instead of that, if you go for 11 small modules, then even if one system fails, then other can share the power. Therefore, the reliability is somewhat maxed in this kind of coil of generation. That may be the another reason. So, the maintenance is easily possible. And in case of reliability is highly ensured, and if you go for higher level generation, the reliability may not be ensured. And as I told that, one technical reason is insulation, and in the other way, so that we can think in some other ways also. These are the two best answers for that. And one more thing, one more technical reason I would like to share is that in kind of generation, if you want to tap the power from the rotating part to the fixed part, then again it is very much complication, and regarding the brushes, the collection of brushes and other things, because power which is tapped from the rotating part and it is transferred to the fixed part is not that much easy, and that is maybe also one of the reasons for low of generation. And now coming to the second question, why we are going for a transmission at higher levels? It's again it's very simple. It's like only in the economic point of view and in the efficient point of view. Okay, in order to maintain an efficient as well as the economic power transfer, we want to boost it up for the higher levels, because the voltage which is generated at the remote area is to be transferred to the load center, which is an industrial area, it may be a city area or a lot of people which are there. It has to travel a long distance. If you want to transmit the power for a long distance, then we need to step up for a higher level. So higher level of voltage is to be transmitted in order to maintain the efficiency, because we have line losses or the distribution losses, which I will share in another video. Like almost 22.7% of power is lost due to the line losses or distribution losses. In order to meet the losses, we are stepping up for higher voltages. And also in the economic point of view, for the same level of conductor, if you transmit the power with the higher levels, then we can able to maintain the reliability, efficiency as well as the regulation. And that's the only reason we are going for higher level of transmissions in order to have a healthy, good power system network. The third question is, I have a lot of answers, different things, and different authors are saying that 11 kV is only because from the form factor point of view, and for any design we will go for RMS value. we want to have get our RMS values, then we have to multiply the average value with the bump factor, which is like 1.1.1. Any average value is multiplied with the bump factor 1.1.1, and this is going to be like 1.1.1. It means that in terms of current. And some authors and some experts say that it is only because of the form factor point of view. Of course, that may be one of the answer. But in from the history, I would like to share it is not to be like the multiples of 11 million. Basically, when a power system network was initially coming into existence, the voltage levels were only 100 volts. From Edison's point of view, Edison's research or the later researchers says that 100 voltage is the first level of voltage that has been designed, not in the point of transmission or multiples of level or like that, only in the point of the lighting loads, the first bulk with electron filaments, carbon electron filaments are basically supported with the 100 volts capacity, and that's why they designed in 100 volts. In order to transmit the 100 volts for a long distance, they just added some 10% and they just set up a generation system like 110 volt of generation system. 10% is for the losses and 100 volt will be for the supply to the load. And from the literature, I have seen it need not 11 kV modules. I have seen 138 and 380 volts and so on. And of course, I'm still making some literature review on those things with the good answers. Once again, I'll meet you in the next video. And thanks for patient listening in this video. Kindly go through this and comment on this. And if you like, please share it. I'm waiting for the comments and from you.